Over the last semester, 8 other students and I have been looking into the problems and issues regarding affordable housing in Asheville. We've been working with local agencies and nonprofits and people who have been working through these affordable housing programs to learn about the policies and problems around this issue.
We are facing a serious problem. More people are becoming homeless, and yet we're not getting the funding.
Mm-hmm.
And we're like, what are we gonna do?
Yeah.
It's scary.
Affordable housing is it's so much more than just like a place to sleep at night. It's more about like a quality of life.
Housing is affordable when housing costs are no more than 30% of an individual's total income. Housing includes utilities, property taxes, association fees, maintenance, insurance, all of those things. So that's a lot of money that one family or one individual has to afford for just to meet their basic living requirements. So if that number of utilities, insurance, maintenance, you know, taxes is bigger than 30% of their annual income, that is no longer affordable. And what we have found in this issue workshop is that's the case with most families, individuals, and people just like us. What I'm concerned most about is what the future of affordable housing is. How that's going to affect not only the people in my community, but also me personally. Because when I graduate from college, I'm not going to be able to afford affordable housing. I won't have that much money to give to basic living requirements. So that's worrisome to me.
Is a program with Mountain Housing Opportunities.
Mm-hmm.
And it was built for affordable housing. And Homeward Bound of Asheville, we have our offices here, but we also have 15 units that are in our program for homeless people with challenges.
We also did some cleaning in the Griffin, which was great. I cleaned a lot, like it was intense cleaning. I cleaned the bathroom, which was, I felt really accomplished after I left. And we also got to meet like individuals, which was really cool, connecting to people on a personal level and hearing their stories and how they've worked with the different organizations we were introduced to. I think that was my favorite part.
Frank gave us a tour about his work, and I just remember his desire and his passion and being so excited about giving these people homes or helping to provide a space for them to find shelter.
But in the last year, we've taken 150 people off the streets and putting them in homes. Because what most people don't realize is that anybody can become homeless. It can happen to anybody, especially what's going on right now.
About 30 years ago or so, the federal government stopped investing new money into things like public housing. And so essentially the federal government hasn't built any new very, very affordable housing in 30 years. And so over those 30 years has been this giant pent-up demand for affordable housing product throughout the country. And in some areas it's greater than others, and just happens to be because of the other factors here in Asheville that there's a great need.
Every day I ask myself, Frank, what the hell are you doing? Why are you doing this?
Yeah.
And every night when I lay down and go to bed, I said, you helped someone today. You know, you took a human being, a soul, and put them into housing, or got them into service for mental health, drug abuse, whatever. And I see them progress like Joey. He was in the streets for 8 years. He's here now. Because I said he needs to be at a home where he can become self-sufficient and enjoy his life. And he's, you can see he's a happy guy. Mm-hmm. Now he's got a life now. So, you know, that's basically it. Here's the worst thing. 2 years ago, the federal government, through the DSS, gave us a grant, which is why we have been working and how we got all these people in the homes that we have. Because of the economic system right now, we were denied it this year.
Oh, wow.
Come June, we have no funding. We give our people hope, and that's what I have to live with. And so far, it's worked out.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, look what happened to me.
Mm-hmm.
But what I want to emphasize is to all you guys in colleges, you really need to let the legislature know what's going on out there with the homeless situation.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's very serious. Because we have, right now, we've had to go around and tell people that we put in the homes that, look, come June, we may not be able to pay your rent. We may not be able to pay your utilities.
Mm-hmm.
Start looking for a job. We need to help you. Because we are faced with the people that we've got back into self-sufficiency in a home, they might be homeless again.
Mm-hmm.
Because we can't pay the rent.
Yeah.
Makes sense to me?
Yeah.
It's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
Get active in your community, either volunteering or learning about the nonprofits or even how the government works or even how the programs work. Getting a greater knowledge will give you a better chance of helping to affect change in the future.
This workshop has really showed me, it's like connected the dots between all the different organizations in Asheville related to homelessness and affordable housing, and it gave like a really like broad, full spectrum picture.
Keep your empathy and your compassion and your kindness, because you keep us going. Y'all give us hope.